welcome. I set up this for you so you could learn how to play Italian cards. There's different games to play when you play with this kind of cards. You can play Briscola, you can play Trisette, you can play Assobiatutto. There's a lot of games that you can play. But today we're gonna show you the cards and what they mean for when you play Briscolas. Basic rules to play Italian cards. There is four suits: the scoppe, bastoni, spada, and denari. Each suit of cards has got 10 cards. So you got the ace, the 2, the 3, the 4, the 5, the 6, the 7, donna, cavallo, and the re. Okay, these cards and each cards are the same. If you go through them, they'll have 10 cards. Now, each card's got its worth different points. If you get the, this is denari again, if you get the ace, it's worth 11 points. The 2, nothing. The 3 is worth 10 points. 4, 5, 6, and 7 are worth nothing. The 8 is worth 2 points. The 9 is worth 3 points. And the king is worth 4 points. Now again, I'm saying these words in English and in Italian. In Italian it would be re, 4 points, cavallo, 3 points, and donna, 2 points. I want to show you a couple basic rules of Briscola. So the main point of the Briscola is that you have to beat the other person's card. So the card that has the major points is always the card that's gonna win. So the ace is the best card, it's worth 11 points, and can beat any of these cards when thrown on top of it. Okay, right now I wanna show you how playing Briscola works and what the basic rules are. So usually you would have two players. You get the cards get mixed. And again, Briscola could be played with two players, four players, or six players. That's how I've seen it played. I'm sure there's other ways that Briscola can be played, but I currently not aware of. But I hear that the most fun playing Briscola is in six players, even though the most played is probably like two and four players. There is a very, there's a lot of hidden rules in Briscola and the way to play, and what people think is right or wrong, or undefined rules of Briscola. But here it is, you mix the cards nice, the other person, will lift the card if you're given, or before you do that, you decide who gives the cards. So by deciding that, the one player will lift a card, so I just lift the 9, the cavallo, that's 3 points, the other person will lift the other card, you got the ace, that's 11 points. That means that that person is gonna give the cards. So let's pretend that I would have to lift the cards for that person. I lift the cards, these cards go on top, and we start dealing. We give 3 cards each. It's very important that you don't give all 3 cards at once. Some people do that, but it's not recommended that you do that. I'm just gonna lift the cards. You wouldn't do that in a regular game, but I just for the sake of showing how it works, so you understand better what's going on. Okay, this is the way it works. So right now you see that the Briscola is a denari. So the Briscola is denari. So that will be your jolly card, the card that's got the most importance. This one card here, there's 9 cards in the whole deal, on the whole deck of cards that will have denari. So that's the card that you wanna keep in your hands, and the card that's gonna be on top of everything else. So let's say, so I dealt cards. The other person goes first. So the other person's got 2 Briscolas. He throws a card that's not meaningful to him. It's just worth 2 points. So I have a card that's worth 11 points, one card is worth 10 points, and I can go what's called liscio. that means it's got no points at all. So I'll give him a Alicia. It doesn't have to be the same suit, and he picks it up, and that's 2 points for him. He picks up another card, puts it over here, and now we the same situation. He's got two Briscolas. He throws Bastoni. Now this is worth 4 points. The three of Bastoni goes on top of it because it's worth 10 points. So I pick it up. So that would be 14 points for me. So this time I pick up the card. And I pick up a Briscola. Now, one thing I want to show you, you wouldn't do that in a regular game, but let's say I throw this card, which is Spade, and it's 11 points. Usually, for what you understand as right now, this card will win over everything because it's an ace. But that's not the case, because even a small 5, small Lisha otherwise, just because it's suited as a Briscola, I could pick it up. So, you just made 11 points using a small Brisk, but you, again, you wasted one, or you just used one for 11 points. So you pick up another card. And the game goes on and on like this. There is other rules. Again, small rules apply to Brisk. If a Brisk, you have a bigger Brisk, of course you pick up. Until you get to the end of the game and you count your points. Now, if you would have used all these cards, you would have to understand that, let's say if we just play the game, you would have to make 60 points. So it's 2, 11, 13, 17, 20, 23, 25, 29, 31, 34. This person just made 34. That means that this other person made 86. Because the total points of Briscola is 120. So it's 10, 14, 24, 26, 37, 48, 51, 61. With this you already win because you just have to go over 61. But just for the sake of throwing someone's face how many points you did, 71, 75, 86. So this is a basic ruling of the Briscola. And again, I'll go over something some more. So this is Denari, Coppe, Bastoni, and Spada. These are, the four suits of cards that you gotta think of. This is worth 11, this is worth 4, this is 2 Lishas. And you can go on and on to see all the other cards that altogether make Italian cards so interesting. But this was just a Briscola 101 lesson. And if you have any questions, just send me a comment and I'll go over with you with some more information on how to play Briscola. And if I forgot anything, just let me know.